What's up, farming friends? It's me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose, and today we're doing a little tutorial for Farming Simulator 2017. As you can see, we're going to be talking about the conveyor belt system, a great new feature of Farm Sim 2017 that will allow you to pick things up off of the ground and move them from one place to another. And with the new Tip Anywhere feature, this is going to be something that you really want to invest in and have available, because it will come in handy in quite a bit of situations. So let's take a look at it. There are four pieces of machinery that you're going to be using, and we'll look at them first in the store, and then we'll demonstrate them for you guys. When you come into the store, they're going to be all the way over here towards the end under belt systems. Double click on that and you'll see the four pieces of equipment. You've got the Lizard S710. This is an essential. This one picks everything in the game up off of the ground, and it is the starting point of your conveyor belt system. So this one right here is going to be the one thing that you really want to pick up. As you can see, all the different fruit types down at the bottom that can be picked up, basically anything in the game. Okay, so just think, this is universal. It's going to work with everything. It's the beginning of your conveyor belt. And this guy over here, it's the very end, the SL8022 Quantum. This is what actually takes everything that's on the conveyor belt and distributes it to wherever you want to put it. So let's say you want to move some grain off of the ground into a tipper. You're going to pick it up with the S710. That's going to transfer it onto the SL8022 Quantum, and then that's going to run it up and tip it off into the trailer. Let's say you got a trailer full of sugar beets and you want to put them under a shed. You can put this S710 down, dump everything out on the ground. The 710 will take them up, put them on to the SL8022 Quantum, and that can be then distributing them into the shed for you, and you can telescope out and you can put it all in there. So these are the two most critical units of the conveyor belt system that you're going to want to have. The other pieces of machinery, just some add-ons. The Grim RH2460 is for potatoes and sugar beets, and I wondered why this was even in the game if you've got the S710 that does everything. But this is more of a it's not so much for the conveyor belt system as it is, has a little feature that it will allow you to create pallets of potatoes and sugar beets that you can then pick up with your pallet fork, of front end loader, telehandler, wheel loader, whatever you want to use, and then you put those onto a trailer and truck them off and sell them. So that's what this is primary use is. However, it does have a secondary feature which does allow you to disable the pallet feature, and then potatoes and sugar beets that are inside of it are whisked up the conveyor. They're distributed out the back here, and if you align this piece up with the back of this piece, they will actually come out of here, go onto this, and be distributed out. So you can use it as a starting point for the conveyor belt system as well, but it really is in here to make pallets if you want to use it for that. So that is the RH2060. And then the last piece in the conveyor belt system is your TC8016. This is an intermediary device that you can use in the conveyor belt system just to lengthen it out a little bit. Let's say you've got a span, a stretch that is a bit more than the connection of this unit and this unit. You want to lengthen the whole thing out. Maybe you need to turn around a corner. That's what this is for. This is the TC8016. Basically, it would hook up to this device. Everything would come up here, go down this one, deposit onto this one, and then be distributed out. Or you can put two or three of these in a row, whatever you need to do in order to lengthen out and be able to cover the area that you want. That's what this particular device is. So as things go, the most critical pieces that you're going to need in your inventory are your S710 and your SL8022. They are must-haves. The rest of this stuff, it's all just add-ons that if you want to get them, they're nice to have, but you really need these two items for your conveyor belt to function. Price-wise, $5,000 for the S710. You can rent one for $550 a day. You can pick it in whatever color you want it. For the RH2460, you're looking at $19,000 to purchase it or to rent it for $2,090 a day. The Grimmy is the TC8016 is $8,000 or $880 a day on your lease. And then finally, you have your SL8022 Quantum for $12,000. You can also lease that for $1,320 a day. Now, one of the things you're going to see in the system, in the menu, is you're going to see your maintenance cost is $10 a day, but you're going to see miles per hour, and you're going to see 30 horsepower. Why in the world would that be there for a conveyor belt system? Well, one of the things that is interesting about these is they each act like a little individual tractor. And Giants did that because you need to be able to position these, right? Now, as you look at the front of them, all of them have a tow hitch. You can hook these up to a tractor. You can tow them out to the field and place them wherever you need to do it. But once you get them there, you need to be able to fine tune the placement of these. And you do that by getting inside of them. Now I'm going to show you that with this one right here. I'm going to jump inside of it. And this is our SL8020. If we open up the help menu, you'll see it has stop engine, start engine, stop engine, start engine. I had this running just a minute ago so I could position it into place, but you would normally find it with the engine turned off and you'd hit your inner key to turn the engine on. Now it's not going to make any noise, but once you do, you can use your WS, A, and D keys to make this thing move around and you can position it to where you want it. Now I'm going to back it up and get it out of the way so we can start to position things around because we're going to move a little bit of sugar beets here so we can showcase this whole conveyor belt system. Now I'm gonna do two different things. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull the sugar beets out of here and load up a tipper for you guys and just show you how to do that using just the 710 and the SL8022. Then we'll make a more complex contraption and we'll explore how to use this as well. So let's start with the 710. Now on the 710, you've got your trailer hitch right here in the front. You want to get that up out of the way to move this thing because if you don't, it's not going to steer for you. So hit your X key. That will fold up and then we can pretty much drive this thing wherever we want. You want to try to be on level surfaces with these. Not a whole lot of hills, not a whole lot of bumps. They don't have a whole lot of power. So hopefully you're in a situation where you can get it to move around fairly easily because they can be a little bit fun to move. But as you see, I've got some sugar beets already starting to load up in my little conveyor here. And I'm just going to pull this up in here so it's a little bit into my pile. And now that I've got it placed, I'm just going to go ahead and leave it right here because that is all I need to do with that particular unit. Once it starts to fill up with sugar beets, you know that you've got it working. All right, so we'll get back into this guy and we're going to move it around and we're going to place it. Now I want you to look up on the menu bar, on the help menu, and you see under controls at the top, the mouse keys are illuminated for both the left and right mouse keys. That's because there's a couple of extra features for positioning this. If I hold down my left mouse and I move my mouse up and down, you notice the main boom is going up and down. All right. If I hold down my right key and I move my mouse to the side, left and right, it's going to make it extend. And this thing extends a pretty good piece out here. Now the controls of this are the exact same controls as you would use for running something like a Buffalo or a Ponzi Scorpion. So if you've rigged up dual joysticks or even a joystick on your computer, you'll be able to control that boom by using the same control that you use to extend out the boom on a Buffalo. That's going to be on that same axis. As far as raising and lower, it's going to be on the same axis that you use for raising and lowering the main arm on the Buffalo or the Scorpion. All right, so that might help you out a little bit if you do happen to have joysticks. Otherwise, if you use a mouse and keyboard, you'll just use your left mouse to raise and lower and your right mouse to push that in and out. So we're going to go ahead and scoot this right up underneath there. And as soon as I do, you notice I get a little bit of sugar beets coming out of here. And this thing is ready to work. So if I want to, I can raise this thing all the way up and get my height up. If I want to extend that boom out just a little bit, I can. And at this point, we're ready to work. Now, there's one more little feature on this that is pretty cool. If I don't like where this particular device is setting right now, so it's pointing kind of straight out. If I hit the X key on my keyboard right now on this particular unit, notice the wheels, how they cantilever in. That gives me the ability now to using W and S just to pivot this. and I can change the angle of it, and it'll pivot right where it's at. This is a pretty nice feature. So we're going to pivot it out so it's right about there, and that's going to put that right about in the center of the road. And at this point, we're pretty good to go. Now, there's one other little thing I haven't shown you, and that is on these two particular devices, you notice how they've got sort of a little hitch pin right here and a little hitch coupling. If you look, and I'm going to open up my GPS, not so I can use it, but so I can hold down control and get a cursor. You notice down here in the bottom right-hand corner, there's a hitch icon. If I hit Q, these two devices will hitch up together. If I want to unhitch them, though, now you have to be kind of careful. You have to notice the unhitching is done from the front unit. See down here on the right underneath the speed, there's two little blocks right here. When you start clicking these together, you make a chain. And using your G key, which you use to cycle through your implements, I can switch from the rear unit to the front unit and so forth. If I want to unclick these, I have to switch to the front unit, which is actually the back in the list of chain. But then you notice I say get detach, which is Q. I can detach them and I can make them separate. You can use this either separate or connected. Connected just helps you if you're going to be moving it around any to only have to move one unit and drag both of them along at the same time. So it is helpful to have them connected together. And for the purposes of this demo, I'll go ahead and connect the two of them together. I have them connected up. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of my GPS. I was just using that for the cursor. And now that those are connected up, just to show you how this whole thing works, I got a little tractor and trailer here sitting ready to go, and we are going to fill it up with some sugar beets. So let's go ahead and start her up. And all I have to do at this point is just back right there underneath that trailer or underneath that conveyor belt, and we will start getting a whole bunch of sugar beets into this trailer. And there's a pretty good amount of sugar beets at one time. It's not super fast, but you are going to get quite a bit of goods in here. So there we go. So we start getting a nice stream of sugar beets in there. And you'll notice that if we jump out of the tractor and head inside, we are picking up sugar beets right here. It has a pretty decent pickup radius, but at times if you're like trying to pull from a bulk stack like this, you are going to have to reposition it every once in a while. And that's where having these hooked together will come in handy, because you'll only have to jump in one piece of the equipment to move it. Now, they are a little unstable. I will tell you that it's almost better to move them individually, because sometimes if you're like trying to pull at this angle, this one will try to tip over, or they'll start to lay over. They are a little bit unstable. So unless you're trying to pull a straight line, I wouldn't necessarily advise trying to drag a whole chain of this stuff, because it might not work out for you. But anyways, you can see we're starting to gather these up. We're starting to get them moved out of here. And we're getting a whole lot of sugar beets loaded up, and they're out. So that's the basic operations of it, just using the 710 and the SL8022. And this is going to be probably the method that most of you guys use anytime that you're using the conveyor belts. But we do have this one over here with the TC8016. My, wouldn't it be nice to throw it into the mix. So let's go ahead and stop this whole little operation. I'll do so by just moving the trailer out of the way, and we'll make a little bit more of a complex operation here, and we'll explore how to use these a little bit further. So I'll move this out of the way. And just go ahead and kill the power on there, because I don't want to rack up any extra hours on my engine. And we'll come back over here, and I'm going to jump in to the SL8022. And I'm going to go ahead and straighten it up just a little bit. And then I'm going to disconnect. And again, I'm going to have to switch over to the front implement. Go ahead and hit Q to disconnect. And now that I have them separated, let's go ahead and turn my wheels in, so that I can drive this guy. And I'm just going to pull him out of here, straighten him up out of the way a little bit. And I'm going to zoom out so we can see what we're doing. I'm going to pull in my bar. Pull the whole thing forward just a little bit. And we're going to set this out here to put the sugar beets right back where we just got them from. And this will be an easy demonstration for you guys. Lower this down. Back her up some. And let's go ahead and swing it around so we're straightened up here. Looking pretty good. All right. I'll go ahead and lengthen that out so that we're putting it all the way up in there into the pile. This piece is pretty much placed where we want it to be. I'll go ahead and cantilever those tires out so this thing can now pivot and put things wherever we want. It's hitting a little bit on something in there. It probably is that conveyor belt. Yeah, it's probably a conveyor belt. That's okay because we're going to move it out of the way. All right, so we'll jump up into this guy here and we'll go ahead and move the 710 out of the way just by backing it out of here. And we'll move it. Let's just pull it around the corner and get it completely out of the way for now. All right, so with that out of the way, we're going to grab our intermediary and we're going to use it, which is our TC8016. We'll grab it, and it steers just like the other one. We'll go ahead and pull the help menu up. It's got a few different controls on it as well, but the most important thing you want to realize about this is the front of it here, where it's got the big black pan, is the front and where the anything needs to be deposited into. So this is the front of your hopper, and this back here is the back of the hopper where things are going to fall off. So when you position this, you're going to want to position it so that the black pan or the lower end of it is out where you want it to be. So in our case, we're going to want to have the back end here back by the SL8022. So we're going to back up here. And to raise this up, we'll just use again, we've got some mouse controls. Left mouse does two different things. Up and down is going to raise the rear end of it. Right and left is going to pivot this front piece, and I'll get into that in a minute. Right control raises and lowers the front wheels here. And side to side on it spreads this out a little bit. All right, so it telescopes out, and it's actually two pieces together. So once you get that out, you can actually slide this around, put it wherever, and remember I told you could like bend around corners with it. That's what that feature is going to be for. Well, we will, first of all, we want to get it positioned into place to where the back end rests right over the top of our hopper here. So that's the most critical part that we need to do. So let's work on that first, and then we can worry about getting the other part into place. So we'll get this in, and this is much like connecting up with the 710. If we jump into here, into the Quantum, you'll see that we've got a connection piece. So we can go ahead and connect those two up, and that is one unit now. Now with those two in, we can jump back into this one, and we can worry about positioning the front of it. On the front of it, we'll just go ahead and we'll maybe steer this over to the side a little bit. This is where it all gets just a little hanky. I'm just going to turn this over to the side some. And we'll get that piece up there. It gets a little unstable, so you got to work with it. And just be careful when you're placing everything. But we've got that pushed over to the side. Now, for the front of it, we can put one of two devices on there. We can put the 710 on it and grab things right off the ground, or we could use the big hopper over there. Now, just for demonstration purposes, I'll go ahead and grab the S10, and we'll go ahead and the 710, and we'll put it in place, and we'll use it. But we're gonna do a little bit of everything today, just to demonstrate all the pieces of equipment, show you how to use a little bit of everything. So again, I'm gonna get this piece into place, and again, I'm just positioning using my WS, A, and D keys. We'll get this into position here, like so, and see how it puts stuff there. Everything's traveling along the conveyor belts. All is good. The last thing that we have to do in order to dump into here is we have to jump into the SL8022 and we have to enable it to actually distribute to the ground, which is your left control and your eye, just like it is in every tipper in the game now. So if you want to unload on the ground, you have to use the unload here function. So with that done, now we're starting to spill out sugar beets back into the hopper. And if I wanted to position this a little bit, I could use the pivot function to slowly move those around and position them out. So that's the way you can do everything, pull things off the ground. And like I said, just so that we demonstrate a little bit of everything during this video, I am going to just go ahead and start this up. We'll put a little bit of sugar beet on the ground here and showcase this out just a little bit. And then we'll grab the other piece, bring it over, and we'll show you a different way that you could do this for sugar beets and potatoes as well. So let me try and get this all lined up here real quick for you. We'll go ahead and enable ground deposit on this one with left control I, and that shot a little bit of sugar beet out, and that did the whole process and got it all going. I could do a little bit more, try not to put a big huge pile up there because it might not all load in. I'm going to go ahead and disconnect this real quick. I'm going to pull this all forward some. Get rid of that help menu. I might not be completely lined up back there. So let me get this out of here. We're going to drive around. I'm going to go get the other piece hooked up and bring it over. And we'll work with the last piece of the conveyor belt system, which is the sugar beet and potato hopper. Back up and connect that up. There we go. And we'll bring this around here and be ready to use it. So again, like I said, I was a little bit off with the conveyor belt, and that's where hooking everything in together might help you out a little bit. If you've got all this connected up, you might not miss a little bit. So you could grab this guy here and again, I got it a little bit out of the way. Sometimes when you dump, I have found, like if I dump stuff out on the ground, sometimes this 710 wants to kick around a little bit and it will unposition itself and you'll have to reposition back. But I've also found that I sort of like not having them connected together because it does do that. Like when you dump out and it hits it a little bit, it will sometimes make the whole thing flip out and knock around and knock it on its side or whatever. So one of the things I have found is helpful is not to connect these two pieces right here. And again, like what I said is I have found that sometimes when you back up and you dump a load down on the ground for this thing to pick up, the load will actually cause this piece to kick around a little bit. And when it does, it causes a chain reaction and all of these other pieces kick around and sometimes flip around and the whole thing freaks out and wigs out. So I prefer not to connect this piece up right here. That way, if this piece freaks out, it doesn't chain react through the whole system. So you may find that you like to connect the whole thing together for ease of use. But for me, I like to keep this one separate from the rest of them. All right, so with that said and with that done, I'm going to move this piece out of the way because we don't need it. We've basically shown you how to pick things up off of the ground. The last piece that we want to see is this potato and sugar beet hopper and see just how it performs and what you can do with it. So we'll move it out of the way. We'll move this over here to the side where it's not in our face anymore. All right, and then we've got the RH2460 that we want to play with. So this basically has a hopper in the front here that you put your sugar beets and potatoes into. They travel back down through here, and this whole set of rollers and everything, I guess this is modeling to shake it down. In real life, we had something like this on my uncle's farm where it came up there, and this was a sort of like a culling system where the first spacings were to knock out certain size potatoes, like little potatoes would fall, your fingerlings and stuff would fall off of this one, your intermediate grade would fall into this one, and then your final grade would fall into here. But they didn't all fall out one side here like this one is doing. They would, like, they were staggered so that you could put a conveyor belt off of the front one off of this side, a conveyor belt off of this one off of this side, and the conveyor belt off the back one off this side, so that you could actually go into three different distribution areas. Or you could put a bag and whatever to collect stuff. But this particular one, even though it's modeled that it has three belts on it, everything drops off of this back rear belt. So this is the only thing that you have to actually worry about, is where is this slot right here placed? So that's what we want to pay attention to. Now, for demonstration purposes, I'm going to pull forward just a little bit here and actually tell you what, I'm actually going to pull right up here and I'm going to set this on the ground so that we can use the pallet feature first and showcase how it works. If I can learn how to back something up and get it out of the way, that's good enough for me right there. Now, to position this, this does not have the self-positioning capabilities that any of the other conveyor belt systems have. To position this one, you have to do everything with a tractor. We'll open up our menu, and you can see that we have lower the belt, which is V. We can use it to go ahead and lower it down and set it flat on the ground. And then you see that enable pallet creation is button I. So if I want to do pallet creation with this one, I just go ahead and strike I. And now if I dump potatoes into this or sugar beets, it's going to start making the pallets. So we'll disconnect from it. We'll drive up here and we'll get our trailer hooked back up. And then I will dump a load of sugar beets into this. And we'll see how it does. All right, well, that connected up. Now all I got to do is do this properly and back up a trailer. Now you want to get straight up on this. This is the other thing that we found when messing around with it in multiplayer, is you do want to get straight up on this and get right in between the black skirts here when you load up on this. Otherwise, when you tip, you'll have a tendency to knock it out of the way. But this is good enough, and we'll go ahead and use, I want to make sure that I'm not dumping on the ground, which is fine, and I just want to dump out as I normally would, hitting I, and it should, there we go, there's the tip icon, and now I can just dump right into it, and as you can see, as it starts to work, it dropped a little pallet out on the ground there and started to create a pallet full of sugar beets. Now, the one thing this does is, as that fills up, that is going to stop the whole process once that box is full. So as you can see, it's filling up, it's filling up, it's filling up, and oh, it's full, and the whole process is stopped. I've still got sugar beets in there, and I can still actually dump more sugar beets into it. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead and dump the rest of the sugar beets out of this trailer into there, because remember, it'll hold 16,000 liters of sugar beets actually into that hopper. But once it creates one pallet, until that pallet is moved out of the way, that particular unit will shut off. So we would have to get a forklift or telehandler or something to come in and get that pallet and actually make it, get it out of the way before it would start up again. And I'm just curious, I haven't tried this because I haven't used it for pallets. I'm going to turn the pallet thing off and we're going to have a little bit of fun with this. I'm going to hit I and I'm going to disable the pallets. I'm going to drive up here a little bit and I'm just curious about this. I wonder if you could use this somewhat like a bale handler or a baler and take it out into the field. And let's say you dump your potatoes into this hopper because it will hold 16,000 liters, right? What if we stop in the field, put a whole bunch of sugar beets into it, and then when it fills, just pull forward slightly with it? This is one of these things that I just thought of just a moment ago, so curious to see if it works. It's pouring them out. Sure enough, as soon as that fills up, Now we'll just pull forward slightly and see if it kicks out another one. Sure will. So you could take this as a in the field and almost use this like an auger wagon. You could take this field side while you're harvesting potatoes. You could run this out, unload 16,000 liters out of your potato harvester, collect them up in here like so, then just go over to the side of the field where somebody else is sitting with a telehandler, and you could just sit here and do this whole process over and over, and it would sit here and make box after box of potatoes on the side of the field, much like you would do bales field side. And then somebody could come up with a telehandler and actually pick these up, put them on top of a on a trailer, and then those could be taken over to a sell point if that is something that you fancy and you would want to do. Now I'm going to deactivate the whole pallet thing because I'm not really into that whole side of it, because that seems like a whole lot of extra work for me. But the last thing I want to do is I want to take this thing full of sugar beets still over here and show you how we can use this with the conveyor system. Now I've disabled the pallet collection system, so at this point nothing's coming out. There's no button I need to strike for this, but the trick to this is I have to line that back little piece up with that big brown hopper or black hopper that was on the front of our conveyor belt system, and it's a little tricky. So I'm just going to slowly back up here. And this would be something that once you had it in place, you would just drop it and leave it. And then truck after truck could come in. We set this actually up the other night on multiplayer. We actually set it up and did it this way. Once we figured out how to do it, we put this particular piece right next to the conveyor. And I'm going to get it right next to it, like right about so. And at this point, I should be able to hit V to make it set down. And there we go. And I'll just disconnect from it so it's sitting flat. And then I'm going to go back here. And this is active at this point and ready to work. All I have to do is get this pan right here underneath that conveyor. So I'll jump into this particular unit. And then I'll come up here to the front. And what I want to do is I want to lower down those front legs just a little bit. So we're going to lower those down. And I'll just scoot it underneath there. And now the whole system's going to start moving those sugar beets up that conveyor. And it's going to move them up onto the last part. And those will get developed and those will get distributed into the entire system. So that's just one more way you can use that hopper and make yourself a nice little thing. So now you've got this set up. Truck after truck could just come up, dump the sugar beets into this hopper, and then you can use them to distribute them into the shack here. You could jump into this guy, and like if you were getting too big of a pile here, well, then you can just take and you can use your W key to turn your conveyor belt a little bit more over to this side and distribute them into there like so. You can raise and lower that to however you need to put things in here. So it's a pretty neat little feature that you can use. It's something you're going to want to play with, figure out how to use it best for your gaming, and it might be something that you use a lot. I've been cutting wood chips, putting wood chips on the ground, and I find it's nice to have the conveyor system after you get just a ton of wood chips on the ground to be able to pick them up using the conveyor system, load up a bunch of trucks, and take them off and sell them. So anyways, that's a look at all four pieces. I hope you guys found that informative and hopefully it's going to help you out when you are doing your placement. Just the biggest thing is make sure you look at the menu system for each one of these devices and figure out how to manipulate them using your mouse. And again, all the information is in your help menu. If you look at the upper top of it, the green buttons, the mouse buttons, will show you how to move things. Again, on this particular one, on the 8022, it's just moving it up and down with the left mouse button. The right mouse button is going to allow me to extend or contract the telescoping feature of the conveyor belt. X is going to help me cantilever those tires so I can either drive it forward or backwards. And then, of course, don't forget, if you want to disconnect, you have to switch to the unit that disconnects. In this case, it would be the back one, so I would have to hit the G key to go ahead and detach, and I can detach these units, or I can reattach these units. And that's about it, guys. Like I said, typically when I want to move something around, I usually detach them and move each individual unit, because they still are a little unstable and they will mess around. And again, I do recommend that if you're using the 710 in a dumping situation where something is pulling up and dumping, two things. One, drop this front leg down too. Hit X. Once you've got it in position, hit X. That will help a little bit with the stability. I forgot to do that earlier. But then also, don't attach it to the secondary piece of the conveyor belt, because if this does get knocked around, let only it knock around. If you've taken time to do something like this and place all this in place, yeah, make sure that you don't have to replace all that stuff. So just don't connect this one to this one. So anyways, that's how you can use all of this equipment, guys. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, make sure you smack that like button. Feel free to share it with all your friends, and come on back and join us for our next video. Until then, Mr. Moose, stay safe, have a great day, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's video, and if you did, I hope you consider giving it a like, maybe even sharing it with your friends. It does help me out a tremendous amount and is greatly appreciated. Also, leave some comments down below. That's really the only way I can gauge if you guys are enjoying what's being put out. Be sure to subscribe to the channel if you want daily notifications. I try to do a new video each and every day. Also, if you want to stay in touch with me and find out what's going on, our social links are down in the bottom left-hand corner. Twitter is where I usually announce schedule changes, live streams, and new video releases. Facebook's a great way to get in touch with me if you have any questions to ask. And of course, I am trying to get to 1,000 followers on Google+, which I know I'll probably be old and gray before that happens. But if you can jump over there and follow me, it would be super awesome. So if you like today's video, there's a whole lot more content on the channel. I hope you'll browse through it, find something to keep yourself entertained until the next video or live stream. Speaking of live streams, I try to do them nightly around 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. Until the next time, thanks again for watching. See you soon.